This week on Maker Update, keeping a close eye on DIY Nerf blasters, a Mixtape MP3 player, the worst job on the Death Star, and a font for your CNC router. Hello and welcome back to Maker Update, the show where we find all the cool projects that makers are making and share them with you so you can get inspired for your own projects. I'm Tyler Weingartner and I hope you're all doing great. We've got a fun show for you, so let's get started with the project of the week. What do volcanic pistols, Nerf blasters, and things with way too many eyes have in common? They're all playing a part of Zack Freedman's latest project, the Ophanim. Fed up with the stagnant nature of DIY Nerf blasters that all function more or less the same, the loader of this blaster takes its inspiration from the real-life volcanic pistol, which lifts each cartridge up into the chamber. It's basically the same mechanism used by the Winchester repeating rifle. Of course, that's easier to do with an actual cartridge because they're rigid and can be easily manipulated by the firing mechanism. Nerf darts, not so much. They're squishy and bendy. Instead, he devised this rotating barrel, which accepts the dart from any of the five magazines and then brings it down to the chamber. It also has this second axis that can detect the orientation of the Nerf dart and flip it around if it's loaded in backwards. To force the dart into the flywheels, he would normally use a solenoid. But to force the dart out of this mechanism he's created, he needs a solenoid with a much longer throw than any that exist. Instead, he's using this pushrod and half-gear mechanism, which does the job admirably. He wanted to create a theme for the blaster with the meme of the biblically accurate angel, the interlocking ring covered with eyes. For the aesthetics, he took inspiration from the game Warframe, whose weapons sport this incredibly ornate filigree Baroque style. And he was coached through the entire design process by his friend and fellow blaster designer Alice Tyrell, aka Coat Duck. The parts that aren't transparent are white with gold detailing, and there's a window so you can see the loading mechanism working. There's also this circular screen with a massive eye staring right back at you while you use it. It's absolutely gorgeous. Zack also shares a great little tip when working through his prototypes. Make notes directly on your prototype in the areas you need to fix. That way, when you go to revise your design, you have a roadmap for what needs changing. Zack isn't releasing the files for a design just yet, but plans to open source the whole thing once it's a bit more mature. More projects. Do you long for the days when you would make mixtapes or custom bird CDs to share with your friends? Sure, you can send people custom playlists, but it's just not the same. Jonathan Rowney has this same frustration, which is why he designed this 3D printable Bluetooth MP3 player that looks just like a cassette tape. And it's all made from components cheap enough that he doesn't hesitate giving these away. Packed into the cassette body is the Bluetooth audio module, a battery, a charging module, and a switch to turn it off and on. There's even four buttons in the printed frame that let you control the playback. Load up your music onto the micro SD card, slide it into the slot on the PCB, and enjoy your new jams. It even fits into a cassette tape case. Well, as long as you trim off the tabs that fit into the sprocket wheels. Through the ARM Maker subreddit, I discovered this diorama of the Death Star laser by Shane of Craft and Quest. The tunnel takes its shape from some spare pieces of PVC pipe, and some texture gets added by using the tread from some rubber tires, bits of styrene, and various other bits and pieces. The laser itself is a straw from a boba tea drink, illuminated by an LED. But the real star of the show here is this hapless technician, whose console is placed inexplicably in the tunnel of the Death Star's main weapon without even a railing for protection. He even added some layers of paint to the operator to simulate the light coming from the death ray. It's super fun stuff. And from Xiao Chen Feng, we have this towering pink Gundam cosplay. You wouldn't know it by looking at it, but nearly all of the armor panels here are EVA foam that's been painted to look like hard plastic. The legs have integrated stilts, and the fingers in each of the hands have actuators that can be puppeteered by the wearer. I also love the look of the wings, which are made from dichroic film. It's an imposing, impressive build, possibly one of her most impressive to date. time for some tips and tools. Stefan from CNC Kitchen has a video that should be useful for anyone who has ever tried and failed to print using carbon fiber nylon. Nylon, or polyamide, has a trait commonly referred to as creep. The material will deform under a constant stress, causing parts to ultimately fail. But if you take the time to anneal your parts after printing, this can dramatically reduce this phenomenon, if not eliminate it entirely. From Contour Leather, we have a helpful video on what you can do to extend the lives of your hobby blades. All blades get dull over time, and when that happens, most of us just toss out the old one and reach for a fresh blade. But you can restore that razor sharpness of your dull blade by honing it. All you need is a scrap piece of veg tan leather and some polishing compound. And by taking a few moments to hone the blade, it cuts just like new again. And over on Instructables, I learned about Jointly, the CNC typeface created by Coby Unger. Typefaces are a tricky obstacle for CNC routers because the radius of the bit means that it can't reach into the sharp corners found in most letter forms. But the design of Jointly embraces this, which is why all those sharp corners are rounded over. But Coby takes this one step further by using the font to create actual joinery, cutting the negative space out of one piece of wood and the positive in its joining face, so you can see the contrasting woods together. It's a clever idea and a gorgeous result. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, we're checking in on Zack, the Byte-Sized engineer, as he gets his tile-based PCB game over the finish line. The goal of the game is to snap tiles together to extend this LED illuminated pathway. He begins by laying out the different permutations of the board that he'll need to create. With the PCBs manufactured and populated, he just needs to program them using a custom programmer circuit that connects using the same pogo pins that let the tiles magnetically snap together. There's a 3D printed case to hide the electronics, and it's finally ready to play. It's great to see the tiles lighting up as the paths extend. Zack has created this game entirely open source, so you can make it for yourself using his code and files. All right, and that is going to do it for this week's show. Thank you so much for watching. A reminder, as always, that you can get more info about every single one of these projects by following the links down in the description. While you're there, leave us a comment, give us a thumbs up, and hit subscribe so you won't miss the next one. Huge thanks to DigiKey for making this show possible, and to you for watching. Take care. We'll see you soon.